My name is Dr. Debbie Saslow. I'm from the American Cancer Society, and I'll be talking to you about our HPV vaccination guidelines and why age 9 matters. I have no financial disclosures. The American Cancer Society updated our guidelines in 2020. The guidelines recommend that all children, all boys and all girls, get vaccinated against the human papillomavirus at ages 9 to 12. That should be the routine recommendation. For children who did not get vaccinated on time, they should be vaccinated as soon as possible after the age of 12 through the age of 26. When that first dose of HPV vaccine is given before a child's 15th birthday, they need two doses of HPV vaccine separated by 6 to 12 months. If the vaccine, the first dose, is given on or after the 15th birthday, then a third dose is needed. We base these recommendations, as we do all of our cancer guidelines, on solid evidence. And this slide shows you some very exciting and the first ever evidence that the HPV vaccine not only prevents almost all HPV infections, prevents almost all genital warts, prevents almost all cervical precancers, but with this paper, we now have solid evidence that HPV vaccination also prevents cancer. We knew that it would, but it took some time until we could see that the evidence proves prevention of cancer and not just the precursors of cancer. So what this study shows, the study was from Sweden on a very large cohort of women, and it shows that those girls who were vaccinated before the age of 17, and in this case, almost all of those girls were vaccinated closer to age 12, that they had very close to 100% prevention of cervical cancer. Whereas when the vaccine was given late, in this case, between the ages of 17 and 30, but in reality, almost all of those women were vaccinated close to age 17, that the protection was only about 50%. And so that's why we emphasize on-time vaccination against HPV cancers. What happens if you are a provider and your patient is past the age of 12 and has not been vaccinated? Go ahead and give them their two doses of HPV vaccine as soon as possible. Or if the child's first dose is after their 15th birthday, give them three doses. They will still derive some benefit, but much less than if vaccination was given on time. This study from the United Kingdom demonstrates how every year that we delay vaccination really makes a difference in how many cancers will be prevented. Like the study from Sweden, you can see that vaccination at age 17 or later has very low protection against cancer. Around a third of cervical cancers are prevented. When vaccination is done closer to the 15th birthday, about two-thirds of cancers are prevented. And when vaccination is given on time, around the age of 12, we do see prevention of about 90% of cervical cancer and 97% of advanced precancers. So this was truly astounding to see the age difference, the difference in effectiveness that just a year or two can make, and the level of protection that we can achieve with on-time vaccination. In 2020, the American Cancer Society guideline emphasized that routine vaccination should begin at the earliest opportunity, i.e., age 9. There are many benefits to recommending HPV vaccination starting at 9, and I will go through 9 of them. So 9 benefits of age 9. Number 1, we get higher completion of HPV vaccination when we start at age 9, it gives us more time to complete the series by age 13. So if a child comes in at age 9 and misses their 10-year-old appointment, there's another opportunity yet when they come in at age 11 or 12 to get that second dose in before their 13th birthday. And this is critical to maximize the prevention of cancer. So benefit number 2, vaccination at early ages results in very strong immune response. We do not know the exact cutoff of when a higher immune response is more beneficial than a lower one, but we do know that immune response decreases with age. So one benefit of vaccinating at age 9 is we optimize that strong immune response. Benefit number 3, we increase the likelihood of vaccinating prior to HPV exposure. Nobody wants to think that young children are being exposed through sexual activity to a sexually transmitted virus. However, not all sex is consensual, and we cannot predict which of our children may be exposed to HPV on the early side rather than the later side. So in order to protect all children, we recommend vaccinating starting at age 9. We'll get the highest benefit, the highest likelihood of vaccinating before first exposure to HPV. This vaccine is prophylactic. It is preventive. It is not a therapeutic vaccine. It will not work once a child has been exposed to HPV. It will not protect that child from precancer and cancer. Benefit number 4, decreased questions about sexual activity from their parents or guardians. We've been saying since the first day that HPV vaccine was approved to present this vaccine as cancer prevention. We don't talk about how viruses and diseases are transmitted for any other transmissible disease except for HPV, thanks to social media. We know that because of what parents may see on social media or hear from their friends or other parents at school, we know that they have some questions when the HPV vaccine is recommended. They may ask, why do I need to vaccinate my child at this age when they're not yet sexually active? And what studies have found is that parents of 9 and 10-year-olds don't ask this question. 11 or 12 seems to be the tipping point where parents start to connect the dots between HPV and sexual activity, unfortunately, and they do not ask these questions at age 9 or 10. And I can tell you as a parent that a 9 or 10-year-old does not want to be sitting in a doctor's office as their mother or parent asks questions of their pediatrician about their sexual activity. So it just makes things easier all around. Providers also appreciate not being pulled into conversations about sexual activity with such a young child. The 5th benefit of vaccinating at age 9 is that it decreases requests by parents and guardians for vaccines that are required for school. Again, unfortunately, there are many parents who will come into their provider's office with their child, and when they're told that their child is due for vaccines at that visit, they may respond, "I only want those vaccines that my child needs to go to school." So other vaccines given at age 11 and 12, namely Tdap and meningococcal, many of the states do require one or both of those vaccines as a requirement, say, for middle school. But most states do not require HPV vaccination. And so all too often, a parent will leave with their 11 or 12-year-old from their annual visit to their pediatrician or primary care doc, and that child will have been protected against Tdap and meningococcal disease, but not HPV cancers. And studies have found that when the HPV vaccine is offered at age 9 and 10, parents are more likely to accept that vaccination recommendation and unlikely to talk about which vaccines may be needed for school. So that's our fifth benefit. The sixth and very important benefit of vaccinating at age 9 is that it decreases the number of shots in one visit. So I just mentioned that Tdap and meningitis are also recommended at the 11 to 12 year old visit. So many parents and so many children say, I just want 2 shots, 1 in each arm, and I'm out of here. And so because other vaccines are not offered at age 9 and 10, other than if it's flu season or COVID shots, but there are no other vaccines that are recommended at the age 9 visit, other than perhaps flu and COVID. And so we don't run into this barrier of parents limiting the number of vaccines given or accepted in one visit. Benefit number 7 is that an increase in HPV vaccinations will increase the number of cancers prevented. So we don't yet have data, as I showed you before, that says vaccinating at age 9 or 10 will be more effective than vaccinating at 11 and 12. But we do have data that show that more children go to see their pediatrician or their provider for their annual well checkup at age 9 and 10 than they do in the preteens and teens. The number of kids going to well visits just drops off with age. The HPV vaccine will only be effective if it actually gets put into a child's arm. And so at age 9 or 10, we're much more likely to see kids in an office visit and therefore more likely to get more shots in arms and more cancers will be prevented. Benefit number 8 is that the HPV vaccine, when offered at age 9, has been shown to increase vaccination rates in health systems. So we have several studies that show quite a dramatic increase in acceptance of vaccine by parents and in the ease of vaccination recommendations by providers. And therefore, the data coming out of these clinics is that their vaccination rates for HPV are higher than when they were recommending HPV vaccine at age 11 to 12. And benefit number 9 is that HPV vaccination, as I've alluded to, is highly acceptable by systems, providers, and parents. It's an all-around win. So I just presented to you at least 9 benefits of routinely offering HPV vaccination starting at age 9. Let's move to the downsides. What are the downsides of offering routinely HPV vaccination at age 9? And here you can see them on my screen. There are none. There are no downsides to recommending HPV vaccination at age 9. The only potential downside of vaccinating at age 9 is if the HPV vaccine protection wanes over time. And we now have very strong evidence that this does not happen. The protection from 2 doses of HPV vaccine and even early data from 1 dose of HPV vaccine shows that this protection is likely to last a lifetime. Therefore, there are zero downsides. No downsides for routinely starting HPV vaccination at age 9. I've mentioned that we have evidence to support this recommendation, and this evidence is growing and has recently expanded. And so the American Cancer Society, in partnership with St. Jude and through the National HPV Vaccination Roundtable, put out a call for papers to expand the evidence base on vaccinating at age 9 to 10. We now have over 20 papers in the process of being published in a special supplement to the journal Human Immunotherapeutics and Vaccines. So with each of these authors, we have invited them to give a short video abstract. These are posted on the HPV Roundtable website. We have, like I said, almost 20 articles already published in the supplement or on their way, and the call for papers is still open, so we expect to get more evidence published. This is to assure providers that this is an evidence-based recommendation to vaccinate at age 9. Now, of these 20 plus papers, some of them are commentaries, some are brief reports, some are surveys, and some are research articles. They span from the Rio Grande Valley to New York City to Washington State to the rural west of the mountain states in the West. And so by doing this call for papers, we have created and expanded the evidence base to support vaccination at age 9. One of the concerns that we hear is from providers and health systems is this inconsistent or consistent with what the ACIP and CDC recommend? And I'm here to tell you that yes, it's entirely consistent. So the ACIP, which is staffed by CDC, the independent federal advisory group that makes vaccination recommendations, recommended starting in 2006 that HPV vaccination be routinely recommended at age 11, 12, or starting at age 9. And so it's merely a difference in wording that the American Cancer Society uses to recommend vaccination starting between the ages of 9 to 12. And the AAP, the American Academy of Pediatrics, also recommends routine vaccination with the HPV vaccine at ages 9 to 12. There are a number of strategies to help offer the vaccine at age 9 because this increases awareness that this is a best practice. And so we have evidence summaries, we have case studies, we have slides that explain why vaccinate at age 9. We have new work with Epic and other electronic health records to forecast at age 9 to help with provider prompts starting at age 9. We have clinic posters, consensus statements, messages, and all sorts of resources to help increase the ability and ease of recommending at age 9. And all of these resources are available on the HPV Roundtable website. If you go to the website at hpvroundtable.org, you can easily click on the resource library. There is a landing page for all of the age 9 materials. They include fact sheets, posters, all of these are print on demand, questions and answers for parents. We have social media graphics that you can share. We have toolkits for people in public health working in their state health department, for payers, for health systems, for providers, for small practices and large practices. We did a communications campaign that was very successful for starting at age 9. And again, all of these resources are available on the HPV Roundtable Resource Library. All of the articles from the journal supplement, all of the video abstracts that I mentioned are available for anyone who is interested. I encourage you strongly to recommend that all of your patients and all of your parents of your patients start the HPV vaccination series at age 9 in order to protect them against 6 different cancers caused by HPV. It will protect them for a lifetime. Thank you so much for listening.